We are now ready to paint the shapes with images. Select the magic wand tool and click on a shape to select all master shapes with the same color, and then click on an image swatch to paint them. Image Paint had just created duplicates of the master shapes and placed them on the clipper image. These shapes are called clipper shapes. For this design, we want to reposition the clipper shapes to match the relative position of the master shapes, because we want the wood figure to flow continuously across the fish. To do this, select the clipper shapes with the Image Paint's Image Picker tool. Hold down the alternative key and then click on the clipper image. Next, we select the rotate tool. Hold down the control key and click drag the clipper shapes to move them. Release the control key and click drag to rotate them. In Illustrator, the control key is used to temporarily switch any active tool to the selection tool. This is why we were able to select and move the shapes while using the rotate tool with the control key held down. As seen here in the layer palette, every time we paint shapes with an image, Image Paint creates a new layer to contain the clipper image and the associated clipper shapes. Note, Image Paint assigned this layer name to be the same as the image name. We use the same procedure to paint other shapes with their respective image. When we click on a painted master shape, the respective clipper image is revealed and the corresponding clipper shape is highlighted. This is useful when we want to select the corresponding clipper shapes to reposition them on the clipper image. We can also reveal the clipper image by double-clicking on an image swatch. Now let's assume that we have another wood image scanned into our computer, and we want to use it to replace the current background of our design. We simply select a new image that has been renamed to match the folder's name, drag it to that folder. Come back to Illustrator and select Menu Item, Browse and Place Image to bring the image into Illustrator. To add it to our image palette, click on the Added Selected Image button. Now select the clipper image we want to replace and click on the newly added image swatch. This feature allows us to quickly replace one image with another image. To select all clipper shapes on the clipper image, hold down the number 3 key and click on the clipper image. To delete an unused image, select its image swatch and click on the Delete Selected Image button located at the bottom of the image palette.